What is up, everybody? Here we are today with some shady jade. So I haven't done I don't think I've done any jade stuff in a little while. I think I did this exact deck like about, oh, I don't know, 10 months ago or something like that. So it's been a pretty long time since I've tried this deck. I think it's probably worse than it was last time I did it, because last time I did it, it was right after Shade release or soon after Shade release. So I think it was completely nuts. I think Jade was nuts back then as well. So I think this deck is going to be a lot weaker than it used to be. But we're gonna play it. We're gonna get some Jade boom booms, which is gonna excite Beck, because you know Beck loves the Jade boom booms. But yeah, we're gonna do some Jade Shade, and we're gonna talk a little bit about if the deck is how the deck is these days. I think a large problem with the deck now that it didn't have before is Pitbull. Previously, the Shade was so kind of broken that Pitbulls weren't really an issue. It just kind of annihilated all War Factory with Shade spam. Now Shade is 60. You can't just trade a Shade for a Pitbull and be happy. You have to kill like two Pitbulls with your Shade, which is pretty tough to do. Okay, so our opponent has Flamers. We're gonna set up the Concave, and we're gonna go Chems immediately. So he's moved it up here. This means that he'll win this 2v1 very slightly, I think. I'm actually gonna not send the Chems in because I wanna see. Looks like he actually still loses it. Feels bad, man. Very close, though. But yeah, we're gonna get Chems. Chems on defense will beat Flames. So, oh, he has Militant and Flame. Interesting. Chems, of course, are immune to this Tiberium. Insane. So I can move them up like this. We want to fire the first missile as quickly as possible, and then, alright, well, that Catalyst Warrior is dead. I mean, like, yeah, you kill my Catalyst Warrior, or Chem Warrior, but you spend 80 to kill my 60 cost unit, so it doesn't really feel great. I don't actually have another answer to Flamers except for more Chem Warriors. So these Flamers are going to come over here. I don't think they're going to get there in time. No, okay. And then we'll just send Chems towards his base. Scarab boys. I don't think these are going to get to attack my Chems. Oh wow, they did. Ripperoni, man. Ripperoni. There goes all hopes and dreams. They're going to walk into that cloud. That's not going to go great for them. Yeah. That was a predictable outcome. Alright, so we're going to try and get Chems to the base, obviously. Because that's an auto win after you win first missile. Or close to it, anyway. If you get two Chems there, it's game over. One is pretty much game over. Alright, well, we get one Chem to the base. That should be GG, honestly. Take out these guys, get an extra cloud down. Fair enough, man. Fair enough. Let's make sure this cloud stays up. Yeah, so the base is basically dead. This is the first time we've built something that isn't our barracks as well. I'm actually just going to pop on these two pads and fire the missile. I mean, there's no real reason to go for the base if he's just going to let me fire the missile. Alright, GG, Jazzman. GG, my dude. He was dead to another Jade missile. There was no hope for him. You are victorious. German Black Ace from blank plus blank. Okay. What do we think blank plus blank stands for? Alright, so I do think moving the Harvester down one tile like this is actually the correct play on this map. It makes you closer to this pad, and it makes you think, I think it's slightly safer to defend it. Smoking a pancake. good one, Jeffrey. I remember that. What was that from? Was it Austin Powers? I feel like it was Austin Powers. It was Austin Powers, yeah. Good times, man. Good times. Alright, anyway, back to the game. So our opponent has snipers. Snipers are going to be pretty good against our deck. Our only anti-infantry is infantry. But the fact that we just killed his first sniper with two militant is making me feel pretty confident about our chances. Yeah, he's not... Not to be mean or anything, but he's not exactly, you know, defending the snipers with the panache that I would expect from a man of ace or black ace standards, you know. You see German black ace, you think there's going to be a little bit more, you know, precision, a little bit more care with his snipers. Alright, so this guy's going to die, which is sad. I was really hoping to just finish the game there, but never mind. We have killed infinity squadrons of snipers now. Alright, here we go. Let's get towards the base. Chems are slow boys. I'm used to my Catalyst gunship base kills these days, which are speedy boys. So, you know, I'm actually going to go crazy here and try and get an extra cloud on these snipers. This is a little greedy. I might get punished for this. Nope, never punished. His base is super dead. Send a couple of shades over. And now no hands. Look at this, no hands gamer. Right here, boys. GG. German Black Ace. He did get my harvester, though. Those the astute members of the public will have noticed he got my harvester, and therefore he is the true winner. Hitch from the Boom Squad. It's funny that he's from the Boom Squad, because I'm going to boom his base. I guess he has Solomon, so there's also potential for him to boom my base. But I think it's way more likely that I boom his base. People will pay for a no-hands challenge. Can you imagine? Can you imagine if someone sponsored a no-hand? How would I even play the game? I don't think I have the dexterity in my feet to win a game of Rivals. I don't think that would happen. I played that challenge one time where I had to lie down. Do you remember that? We did like the fully reclined challenge. that was a weird one. Alright, so he's gone for a Razorback. We're going to just save up for a Phantom, because Phantom one-shots Razorback now. This is a deck you definitely could not play during the Razorback era, because Razorbacks would poop on this deck when Phantoms didn't one-shot them. Obviously, we are no longer in that era, so we can do all kinds of stuff these days. Wow, this talent spam is annoying. Alright, so there goes first missile. It's going to be a little bit trickier to get to the base. We haven't got any money either, because we have to actually build other buildings. In our previous games, we've kind of just won the game on barracks only. Now we've had to build both our other buildings, so we're a little bit broke. Wolverine? Come on, man. Come on, Kitch. Here I am, just trying to blow up your base, and you make a Wolverine? That is not a unit that I can get through. Well, I have shades. I always forget I have shades. I play shades so rarely that when I do have them, I forget I have them. And I'm like, oh, Wolverine, I can't beat that. But actually, shade just annihilates Wolverine. So we can beat that. All right, if you don't want to fight with your zones, I'm down, man. We'll go over here. Yeah, bring that Wolverine over so I can get some more clubs, please. Thank you. Cheers, my dude. All right, GG, Kitch. GG, friend. Got him, boys. Rich Goldman playing Sallyman from Tiberium. Yo, speaking of no hands, actually, Copycat on his channel has a redemption which is nose only, where he plays the game with his nose on his iPad. And I have seen him win games playing nose only. The first time I saw him do it, he won the game with an APC deck playing with just his nose. So there is a world in which you can definitely win with without hands. Copycat has shown us the way. Now, I obviously am on blue stacks right now, so I don't have the ability to play on a touchscreen and use my nose. But there is definitely a world in which it's possible. That has been proven. This is a lot of dogs, man. This is a lot of doggy boys. I'm not even sure if I'm winning this fight. It looks like I'm winning because the missile is red. And it's about to fire. These militants need to live long enough. Alright, nice. What's up with the Grens, Maji? I've only got infantry. Are we going to just go barracks win again? Is he going to go for my half? Is that what he's doing? Alright, you know what, dude? I accept. You go half, I'll go base. Let's see what happens. I am okay with this exchange. Yeah, yeah. He's actually made Grens to... Oh, snipers. No, bad snipers. Ah, snipers is so sad, man. I don't think we're going to be able to get the base if there's snipers. Yeah, because we can kill this first squad, but then another one will spawn and one-shot me, I think. Oh, go! Come on, Catalyst Missile, sooner! Hit faster! Ah, that's exactly what I thought was going to happen. Absolute nightmare. Now look, the base is miles away from being dead. I have to use my hands to win this game. I can't just AFK at all. So this is another thing about these games. Once you get to this stage, the opponent has to defend their base, but also they have to defend the missile, because you can just fire the missile. So you create like this dual pressure. Like he's got everything defending his base, but now the missile fires and he's dead anyway. And also this lol. Omega lols. GG. You are victorious. Alright, up against Fufu. He's playing Kane. Playing Kane is a very smart decision. He's got one harvester and a barracks. Now, because he's built the barracks, I'm going to build a second rifle. If he hadn't built the barracks, I wouldn't necessarily have had the second rifle. And then it might not have been here in time to fight this flamer troop. So, by building his barracks before the unit he was building from the barracks, he's put himself in a position where his flamer doesn't do as well as it would have. Like, my second rifle would have been here much later if he hadn't done that. Anyway, this thing costs 40, and we've traded 2.5 rifle squads for it. So we're up about 15 Tiberium. So this is kind of why flamers aren't amazing. Like, obviously the reason flamers are good, or I think they're terrible, but the reason they're supposed to be good is that you only spend one pop cap on them. So the fact they cost a lot more Tiberium compared to militants is made up for by the fact they're much more powerful for a single pop cap. The issue with that is that they're just not that much more powerful. Like, that's really the problem. And this is one of the decks in the game that is absolutely weakest to flame troops, because I only have infantry to fight infantry. So this is one of the weakest decks in the game to flame troops. Alright, well, he wants my half. I'll accept that trade and go for the base. Well, sorry, mate. Sorry, my G. Probably should have shown some respect to the Chem Warriors. Yeah, that's what you get. That's what you get for not respecting the Boom Booms, my dude. You get Boom Boomed. Bad times. No idea, Terminator, unfortunately. Okay, up against Justin playing Jackson. Jackson, Justin. Probably should really be going rifles before half. I don't really know why I'm not. I think it's greed. Greed and hubris, you know. I'm like, oh, I want the extra 10 Tiberium or 8 Tiberium or whatever from going harvester first. It's actually such a small amount, it's really not worth doing. It's way better to get on the pads. It's way better to scout against... I think just against like every deck in the game, it's just way better to get on the pads and be scouting and so on. Alright, so we can't really scout his base very well, because I don't want to move next to the harvesters and give vision. Alright, cool, so we know he has an air tower. Wow, really? He's built his air tower and then he went shock troopers? That's very weird. Oh, this is unfortunate. Hopefully he doesn't send another shock south, because obviously I don't have an answer right now. So these boosted shocks are gonna... Like, this extra shock is gonna beat my chem, but who cares, right? We're on the other two pads. So it just doesn't matter. It also costs 70 for a shock trooper and a boost, whereas 60 for the chems. So it's really not... It's not even a great exchange there. Obviously, again, there are situations where it's worth it, like... Spending 30 to get control of that pad before the missile fires is worth it, but only if you can get on the other pad as well. If it's the only pad you're on, it's not that great. Ooh, Ruptor? You hate to see a Ruptor if you're a Blade fan here. If you are a Jade Boom Boom fan, you hate to see this Ruptor. Alright, well, the game is almost over. We just need to get to the base. I don't think we can quite no-hands it yet, but we're close. Orca? My G. That's not gonna work. Can I... Ooh, you know what? I might have to kill this Ruptor. Oh, I thought he was going to Ruptor my base, but he is not. I was going to say, I might have to kill the Ruptor if he goes for the base, but he's... Oh, here we go. He's doing it. He's going for my Harv as well, because, you know, he's a Rivals player who's played Rivals before. Actually, going for the Harv is smart. You know what? I take that back. I was making fun of him, but I take it back, because actually, if you kill the Harv, it's really hard to afford the Jade missiles. So yeah, I take that one back. Killing the Harvester is a good play. In fact, I might lose this game. Yeah, never mind. It's close, though. Like, one Ruptor hit plus this nuke, I'd be dead. Yeah, well, close one. Alright, so we're up against Angel Assassin, which I'm a little bit worried about, because, you know, I might be an angel. It's unclear at this point. Okay, so we need to block these wheels, make sure he doesn't get our harvester blocked. This is something that's really... If you go scout unit first, into scout unit first, it's very important to make sure their scout unit doesn't reach your harvester, because they can actually block it off. I'm using the rifles to absorb hits here, and I'm going to block out the second wheel so that my laser gets a 1v1. Alright, I didn't actually mean to move. I did want to kill this wheel off. I don't want to be taking damage from it as I run along. Is he going to go fanatics? Yes. Okay, cool. Probably should have gone chems instead of militants, but I was pretty low on cash monies. So, you know, I was all worried. Let's get the chems now. Oh no. Oh no. Our stuff didn't live long enough. Go Kems, go, 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 go. Go Kems, go, 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 Kems, go, 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 go. Oh, it's gonna be close, boys. It's gonna be close. Ah, oh, the Kems win. Good job, Kems. Now we need to get this here. This here. Oh, there's Seth. Seth is so strong. Alright, luckily, we should beat the Flamers with our Kems. So we should still... Okay, it looks like he spent all his money on the Seth and now he can't afford more units. So we're actually gonna win the missile. Despite the power of Seth at the end of a missile, I think we're gonna win. Because he spent all his money and then didn't have enough for more fanatics and stuff. Or he just chose not to build them. He might have got distracted. It's a big mistake people make a lot of the time. Like, you stop focusing on the on building units because you're focusing on the... You're focusing too much on the fights. Which is a big misplay because it's really important to keep making units if you want to win the missile. Alright, cool. So we... Obviously, fanatics are a little bit weak to chems. It's one of the weaknesses of fanatic decks. We are going to try and... crawl our chem warriors to his base. If we get them there, obviously we win the game. We are just gonna spam chems as well, because at the moment all he has is fights in his wheels. And we'll get some lasers to have efficient answers to the wheels. Yeah, chems too strong, man. Fanatic decks are weak to chems. They always have been. They're not as weak as they used to be. It used to be that chems would beat wheels 1v1, and then you could just never beat chems with a fanatic deck. Now you can use wheels, but I guess confirmed, not an angel. Now, obviously, we didn't use our commander power, so there's a case to be made that Seth was slightly better than Jade in that game. Alright, so we're up against Angel Assassin again. I know he's going to open wheels, so I'm going to open Harvester and then Laser. Although, honestly, like, even if you know your opponent's opening wheels, opening the Militants isn't terrible, because once they get the Fanatics out, you kind of want the... You kind of want the Militant to fight them. I'm not sure if we're supposed to be charging or not. If you charge the missile very aggressively against Seth, you can fire it before Seth is relevant, like, before Seth is off cooldown. Because Seth's initial cooldown is, like, a minute or something. So if you fire the missile before a minute, you can do it before Seth arrives. But if you delay even a few seconds and you get to the point where they can Seth, then they have the advantage. Because if they Seth right as the missile's about to fire, that's obviously a big advantage. So it's kind of close. It's difficult to say if you're supposed to charge or not here. And obviously my deck is less mobile than my opponent's. Like, he's going to send this fanatic down here. Which, if he gets onto the pad, he's not going to, but if he did, then obviously I'd be in trouble. Yeah, I just about blocked it. But yeah, if he got on there, it would have been an issue. And we just about reached the point where Seth had come off cooldown. Alright, so we're going to spam chems. Chems are super duper good against our opponent. Oh, walked into a concave there. Whoops. Alright, more chems. More chemical warriors. Now, of course, the other thing we can do as Jade, we always have the ability to suddenly attack his base. And if he doesn't stop it, then we just win. Like, we can always just walk towards the base, and he gets forced to try and stop it. Which gives us, like, distraction technique and so on. Yeah, I mean, you can see how hard it is for fanatic decks to beat chems, really. It's a huge beating. I'm not even going to fire the Jade missile yet, because I don't think he's going to kill my chem warriors, and I want to try and get the second squad up next to the base. Yeah, here we go. If I can get an extra cloud, it's just, like, going to be instant GG. Ooh, not quite. Alright, well, let's get these bikes on the base. Again, though, like, you can see, we've just done a distraction technique, and now we can just win the game with the nuke instead. Because he's been focusing on defending his base. And that is one of the upsides of playing Jade. You are victorious. Alright, up against Para Dave, which I'm hoping is a Dave who is a paratrooper. That's what I'm going with here. Para Dave, if you're in the comments, mate, let me know. Hoping you're a paratrooper or a paradiver of some kind. That'd be sweet. And he's opened militants as well. Now, we're at, like, he's even double militants. This Spice World. Alright, so he's going to try and take these two pads. That's fine. We'll come down for a 2v1 over here. Given that he's open militant, he's probably playing a very similar deck to mine. Which actually means we should just go chems. Because the first person to get chems on the... Chems beats all the militants. And then if he's playing Jade and he has chems as well. Oh, he has flamers? That's weird. Okay, the fact he has flamers makes me a little worried. Because it means he's probably playing like a cat ship or a chem buggy or something. Chem buggy would suck. Oh, he got bikes here before I could get my thing. Oh, wow, he let the chems on. GG. GG, Paradave. You should have blocked better, unfortunately. Alright, looks like he's going to go for my half because, you know, he's a human being. Apparently that's what you do if you're alive and trying to play rivals. Yeah, I'm actually going to block, which is something that he didn't do. Unlucky Paradave. Feels bad, my dude. Feels the absolute worst. Yeah, man, go for my half. I'm going to go for your base. Let's see who wins. Let's see who wins this race. Base versus half. It's going to be a close one. No, live, Chem Warrior, live. Ah, Ripperoni. Alright, let's get another Chem Warrior over there. Oh, wow, double half. So you're not even playing a Chem unit, you just have Jade for giving you outs. I appreciate that, man. I appreciate that. Do you have a plan for your base? I've noticed a lot of people just don't seem to defend their base. I'm not sure what's up with that. Okay, last game. Up against Old Boy. That was a great film, by the way. Would recommend. A little weird, not gonna lie to you, but it is great. Okay. I'm gonna push in against this rifle, who do you want? Switch targets this guy as it's coming in. Gonna make one more rifle, and then if we keep fighting a rifle mirror, I'm gonna go chems. Okay, it looks like we are gonna keep fighting a rifle mirror. So obviously by going chems this quickly, I win the rifle mirror very easily. But I also force my opponent to tech switch very quickly. Yeah, there's the rhino. So now we have to tech switch as well. I'm gonna go bites because I can't afford the shade right now. Shade is what I'd actually like to make here, but I can't afford it, so I'm gonna go bites. But having said that, shade like doesn't one-shot rhino. I'm gonna retreat in between attacks because, you know, rhino actually does surprisingly good damage. All right, there goes the rhino. Let's shoot this. Oh, he boosted the harvester by accident. Feels bad, old boy. I've been there, man. We've all been there once. Oh, pad control. Go base, go, go, go. Send another chem around the top. He obviously knows. He knows what's happening here. He's going to be focusing on this fight down here. He's not going to notice the sneaky chems around the top. That's what's going to happen. Yeah, you see? Oh, 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 what's up, G? And now he sees. Now he thought he was fighting for his life, but it was all a diversionary tactic. Unlucky old boy. We're just going to shoot the base for a while until something pops out to try and kill us. The more damage we get on the base, the more likely we are to just kill it with the missile. I guess we'll get a couple of bikes and send them over there as well. I think he's probably pop-capped. He's got, like, a disruptor. Disruptor shouldn't one-shot, so we shouldn't lose the chems. Yeah, nice. Alright, base is dead now. Just need to hit with anything. GG. My G. Feels amazing. Feels amazing. I did mean the original Terminator. Yeah, not the remake. I meant the original film. There it is, guys. Some significant boom booms. As Beck says, Jade confirmed better than Disruptor. There you go, guys. Everyone knew Jade all along. I've been saying Jade isn't good, but all along we all knew that actually, if you're already winning the game very easily, Jade just wins the game some more, I guess. All right, cool. Hope you guys enjoyed that. A lot of boom booms. See you next time.